Hey guys, welcome back to RPG Division. In this video I'll try to give you guys a couple of hints how to quest in Velen. Velen is much tougher area than White Orchard, and you will immediately see when you arrive in Velen in this location that the monsters around are pretty high level. You start somewhere around here, I think. Yeah. You can go to this monster then first and clear it. It's a tough area, you're gonna have to be very careful and very skillful to do it. But it's definitely worth it, you'll have plenty of items. Then there are persons in distress here. This is level 9 and level 10. It's very hard to do this. You're gonna have to use some kind of exploits to pull it off, because these enemies can really kill you easily. So I would suggest to stay clear of it, because it's not worth doing it. The thing is that you always need to think about the risk and reward. For example, if you're battling a much higher level enemy that has a skull, red skull, over its health bar, it means you're gonna have to strike them far more than usual to kill them. And when you do so, your weapon's durability lowers itself significantly, and as you may know, getting money in Witcher is not easy and repairs are not cheap. So I would suggest leaving any types of higher level enemies. For example, here is something, I think Basilisk or something, Al-Ghul, I don't know, something level 13, 12, 14, 15, I'm not sure which level, I don't remember, and I suggest leave it for later on. The best bet for you to do stuff in this region is to immediately follow the quest line over here and search, for example, some undiscovered locations that you can, where you can level up. For example, Devil's Pit over here is a good example where you can level up. These are deserters level 9, I think, and you can defeat them. There's not many of them, and you'll get plenty of freaking items here that you can sell. Also, bandit camp here that you can clear, spoils of war over here, a couple of monsters' nests that I've explored, and then I continued immediately to the storyline over here. And here you have plenty of more options. You have shitload of notice boards that you can use to gain new side quests. You can also start doing some quests over here. These are all doable things that I did. These are all around level 6 to 9 enemies, and that's perfect for you. Now there is one place that's, I think it's this, I'm not sure, I think it's this, where there's something of a basilisk as well. I'm not sure, I can't remember which, folktale, something like that enemy. It's a level 14 enemy, level 15, something like that, and this one is much tougher. You can try to defeat it, it's very much doable, but it's gonna take time and it's not worth the effort at the moment. So I would suggest just skip it or try to pick up the treasure without fighting it, it's possible as well. Try to find this monster next, couple of undiscovered locations. These are all locations where you can actually do stuff, because these are mostly your level. Now, these are stuff that will grant you a couple of experience points. Best bet to gain faster levels in this region is by simply doing side quests. You can go for side quests over here by using notice boards, and you will see all of the available ones that you can do and that are for your level. For example, here we have Series Room, Wild at Heart. You can do horse races that will give you upgrades to horses. You have also Witcher contracts. For example, this would be stupid to go and try, but you have these things. You have treasure hunts. This one is broken, I think. And yeah, so be sure to do side quests before you start discovering these locations. It's much more worthwhile. Side quests are awesome, it'll give you money, it will give you plenty of EXP, and be careful with the enemies you choose. Try to wait before engaging higher level enemies. As I said, it's not worth it, because weapons durability will go extremely low very fast. And that's it guys, I hope I helped you out a bit, and when you've dealt with this complete region, maybe a couple of enemies you need to leave because they are too higher level, then start making your way inland, or maybe even south. Look at the region, is fucking huge. I mean, look at this shit. Unbelievable how huge this game is. I love it. I freaking love it. It's up to you how you want to proceed from that point onward, but as I said, focus on side quests at the beginning. Thank you guys for watching. I hope I helped you out a bit, and see you soon.